I said they are acting a movie. You know what I say? Okay, they say there's war, right? Or there's about to be war. Let's pray. Let's do this simple prayer. How many days do you want this nonsense to stop? How many days?
Three days.
1 day. 21 days. 1 day. 1 week. 1 week. Okay. Let's do this way. Father, everybody go down your knees to show you that this is acting. Lord, if you ever spoke to me, Lion of the tribe of Judah, war, this invasion going on in Ukraine,
in the name of
within
Jesus,
now and 1 week, let it end in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let there be a ceasefire in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every demon, blood-sucking demon that has been assigned to kill innocent people, we command you to bow in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let the war cease in Ukraine in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's stand up. Just say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Thank
because
you,
I know
Father.
You.
Holy Ghost, we thank you.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank you and thank you and
put
thank
your TV on
thank
from today,
you, Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank
in
you,
Jesus' name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Russia's defense ministry has declared a 5-hour partial ceasefire to allow residents of 2 besieged cities to evacuate. Humanitarian corridors are now open for people in Volnovakha and the strategic port city of Mariupol in southeastern Ukraine. Mariupol's mayor says the city is without water and power and is running out of food after being surrounded by Russian forces.
After days of relentless shelling here in the key port city of Mariupol, Russia has said it will stop firing and allow civilians to flee. The partial ceasefire was confirmed by the city's mayor and applies here in the nearby town of Volnovakha, which has seen heavy fighting as well. But they're far from the only areas devastated by Russian bombardment. President Vladimir Zelensky has been pleading with NATO to set up a no-fly zone to stop Russian airstrikes like this one outside Kyiv. But NATO has ruled that out. An all-out war in Europe, that's what the alliance wants to avoid, according to US Secretary of State Antony Blinken.